Joining us via Skype is Ganiu Musa, Group Managing Director and CEO of Cornerstone Insurance PLC. Thank you, Mr. Ganiu, for joining us.
Thank you very much for having me. Good evening.
Good evening. How has COVID-19 pandemic impacted the Nigerian insurance sector?
Thank you very much. It's, I would say, impacted the industry in more ways than one. First and foremost, being the human pandemic, we have to look at the, you know, the human cost, which is quite significant and probably the most important area. As at the last count, and even based on the address that we've just heard from Mr. President, we've had almost 1.9 million confirmed cases around the world. Emphasis on confirmation, there are probably a lot more than that, and almost 120,000, you know, deaths. Obviously, back home in Nigeria, we've had over 300 cases, and unfortunately, you know, 10 deaths. These are individuals, these are, you know, Nigerians that have been significantly impacted. So, of course, we do quite owe a debt of, you know, gratitude to our frontline staff, and especially our medical doctors, nurses, auxiliary staff who are, you know, fighting their nights to make sure that we remain safe. Generally, economy has polarized to, you know, insurance. We've seen that economy has basically, you know, ground to a halt. We've just come in on the back of, you know, 2 weeks of lockdown, which has now just been extended, you know, for 2 weeks. The first immediate impact that we see, based on the importance of the economy, is what has happened in the sector. From a high of $72 to the barrel for Bonny Light about April last year, it went, you know, below $19 first of April this year. Obviously, it's recovered, you know, so it's still far below, you know, the budget, levels.
Yeah. Yes.
Of course, we've seen the number of impacts, also especially in the areas of, you know, aviation. Most aircrafts now, you know, ground is affected, you know, tourism. So for us, we are driven as an industry by economic activities, by operations. When airlines are grounded, aviation insurance will suffer, travel insurance will suffer. When businesses close, you know, fire policies, marine policies, because there's no importation, there's nothing. And, you know, basically, you know, so even on the retail side, of course, when people cannot go to work, they don't earn income.
All right, Mr. Ganiu, quickly, Mr. Ganiu, let me interject, Mr. Ganiu, if I'm to interject here. We're running out of time, but I just need to ask you this. When we talk of insurance, we talk of premiums, we talk of claims, we talk of indemnity. Now, have you seen a spike in terms of claims due to this pandemic in recent times?
Well, it's still probably too early to see a spike, but the truth is, and the fact is, will this pandemic result into economic losses, result into human losses? You know, clearly the answer is yes. Some of these losses insured, clearly the answer is yes. I mean, we reckon based on our own, you know, modeling that life offices will be significantly impacted. Yeah, and because of the immediate impact of the, you know, the deaths that will come from the COVID, you know, 19. Also on the general business side, we'll probably see a lot more in the areas of business interruption. We'll see, you know, the claims coming from that area. You know, the insurance circle is such that first, the attention of people is to deal with the, you know, the loss, to deal with the calamity, and then the paperwork for the insurance will come later. So even though we have not seen the spike so far, we do expect that it will come as soon as we get a good hang of the, you know, the human aspects of the, you know, the COVID-19. Yes, we will expect to see quite a bit of, you know, claims coming from this area.
Right. Mr. Ganiu Musa, thank you for joining us and for your time.
Thank you very much. It's a pleasure.